Geothermal energy is a unique opportunity to build industry in communities where it is often missed out most. Building on the history and the tradition of our collieries, but with a new industry that is clean, safe, and can provide both energy and jobs where they are needed.
Currently, the former mine workings are treated as a £3 billion liability for the taxpayer because they have to be kept safe. But these could be turned into a massive stream of income for the British taxpayer.
Geothermal energy is the heat contained within the earth.
The UK has a legacy of abandoned coal fields, which are now flooded with water, and they underlie around about 30% of the UK's housing stock. That flooded abandoned mine contains water that we can take heat from and use that to heat homes and businesses.
This is a huge carbon-free energy resource for this country.
It sounds really exciting when you think about it.
The scale of the resource is absolutely phenomenal. The Coal Authority have completed maps of 23,000 former collieries, and they have a very good understanding of the geology, the engineering, and the feasibility of these schemes. In business terms, this represents a business or a sector which would have a turnover of about £2.5 billion a year. It could also be a source of jobs, especially in the former coalfield communities, which are still suffering economic decline and need regeneration.
It's nice to think that we actually use our mines. Yes, they were dirty, they were nasty, awful places to work, but the comradeship down the coal mine was nothing like it anywhere else.
And just thinking that legacy that was so hard won by the miners that created it could be reused to solve a potentially looming energy crisis in future is a really powerful thing for me.
In 2004, the Department of Trade and Industry estimated that this sector could create 1 million jobs. Let's just compare it to the 300,000 jobs in the oil and gas sector.
Geothermal energy could fit beautifully into the UK energy mix. One of the problems we've witnessed with the transformation of the UK power system into wind and solar generated material is that the wind doesn't always blow and the sun doesn't always shine, but the earth is always hot, and so it provides great base load, something which those two other energy forms cannot do.
The project we've been doing in Spennymoor is really exciting. We identified that there was potential new housing development in the area, and we also know this is a mining town and has a great mining legacy. The Coal Authority currently pump water out of a site near the development site, and that water is warm enough for us to use in a heating system.
I just see it as something positive, and it is putting something back into Spennymoor. And if it does create the cheaper energy, that's absolutely brilliant, you know.
The work we did was a feasibility study, so it just identified the potential. So now this needs to be taken forwards. We need to encourage developers to adopt this technology and encourage the local community to see the potential that this has to offer.
To meet our next carbon budget, it is essential to decarbonise heat. And yet, in the government's 160-page clean growth strategy, there is not a mention of geothermal.
We need to just develop these systems. We have the technology, we know how to deal with abandoned mines, we know how to use the engineering systems that we need, so we just need to do it.
And we're putting something back. You know, we've taken the coal out, we've used it for whatever, but now we're going to use the water.
We will pursue this because it is important and it could be very productive for this country.